Hello everyone, and welcome to the 11th webinar of Photography Club of Cotton University, Pixico. আমি লাষ্ট ইয়াৰ লকডাউনৰ পৰাই লাষ্ট ইয়াৰ লকডাউনত আমি 10খন ৱেবিনাৰ কৰিছিলোঁ এনেকুৱা অন ভেৰিয়াছ টপিকছ ৰিলেটেড টু ফটোগ্ৰাফী। চ' এইটো ছেকেণ্ড ছিজন বুলিয়ে ক'ব পাৰি, লকডাউনৰ ছেকেণ্ড ছিজন, ছেকেণ্ড ৱেভ আমাৰো ছেকেণ্ড ছিজন ৱেবিনাৰৰ। চ' আমাৰ ছেকেণ্ড ছিজনৰ আজি ফাৰ্ষ্ট ৱেবিনাৰত উই হেভ উইথ আছ ডক্টৰ জয়ন্ত বৰদলৈ ছাৰ। হি ইজ ফেমাছলি ন'ন এজ যাযাবৰ। ইউ গাইজ কেন ফাইণ্ড হিজ social media accounts in the same name, Jajabor, in Instagram and also in Facebook. So he's a photographer. He's a really good photographer. We really look up to him. His photos are splendid, incredible. Bohut photos, they're bohut famous huisile. Ami bohut viral huisile, kobo gole. Ami bohut jagate dekhisilu their photo. So Dr. Jayanta Borlase sir is also a nuclear imaging specialist at the Francis Crick Institute in London. So he is our guest today. So sir, over to you. The stage is all yours.
Okay, thank you. So good evening, everybody. And thank you, Photography Club of Cotton College, for inviting me. So I'm presenting something. I don't know if some of you were present during the during my presentation at Gualpara Photographic Society. So I'm using some of the slides that I used before. Okay, as he mentioned, let me explain who am I. So my name is Jayanta Borlai. Moi Guwahati, janma Guwahati hoisile mor. Amar dikholo pray Guwahati thaba, kintu porha khona mor bohut jagat hol. Moi Nagaon asilo kei bochor man. Schooling moi Khoni school Gualpara. Gualpara pra moi Delhi le golu bachelor degree. Tar pasot nuclear medicine at MSc koribole moi golu. বিশাখাপট্টনমত ইন্টার্নশ্বিপ করলো, হায়দ্রাবাদত চাকরি, দিল্লি আর লুধিয়ানাত, তারপর পিএইচডি করব লন্ডন আহিল। সেইটো কারণে মোৰ নাম যাযাবর সোশ্যাল মিডিয়াত, কারণ ঘুরি ফুড়িয়ে আছো অলমোস্ট অল মাই লাইফ। আর বাই প্রফেশন আই এম এ সাইন্টিস্ট এন্ড বাই পেশন আই এম এ ফটোগ্রাফার, মোস্টলি ওয়াইল্ড লাইফ আর ম্যাক্রোটো ইন্টারেস্ট এটা আছে। আই ডু নট কনসিডার মাই সেলফ এন এক্সপার্ট, আই এম স্টিল লার্নিং। I'm just sharing my story, my transition in macro photography. Bohut dangor topic hoy. It looks small, but it's macro. There's a lot of things, a lot of aspects, and you can choose any one of them to be your mainstream, but your interest, it depends on what you want to do. So what is macro photography? In short, horu jodi kobo bisaru, jikono horu bostu eta nijor screenot dangor ke dekhabo paratu macro photography. Subjects can be anything, any small thing. Aru lockdownot hetu suvidha je bahir jabo nalage subjector karone. You can find them everywhere. In fact, in your wall also, jodi ghor wallot chua, you will find jumping spiders ba jethi rupa ba moh. You can photograph them. Aru bostu tu enuka je you don't have to buy expensive equipments. Tomar jikhini hostia নকওঁ সস্তীয়া বুলি, যিটো ইকুইপমেণ্ট আছে সেইটোৱে ইউজ কৰি পেলাই ফটো তুলিব পৰা যায়, বেছি মানে খৰচ কৰিবলগীয়া নহয়। বহুত এক্সপেৰিমেণ্টেশ্যনৰ স্ক'প আছে মাইক্ৰ ফটোগ্ৰাফীত, বিশেষকৈ কিটক লৈ, হাৰ্ডৱেৰক লৈ পেলাই, আৰু এক্সপেৰিমেণ্টেশ্যন নিজৰ স্কিলছক লৈ পেলাইও আছে আৰু আৰ্টিষ্টিক এক্সপ্ৰেশ্যনক লৈ পেলাইও আছে। আৰু মাইক্ৰ ফটোগ্ৰাফী বেচিকেলি কৰিলে কিছুমান এনেকুৱা টেকনিক ইউজ কৰিব পাৰি যায় যিবোৰ বেলেগ ফটোগ্ৰাফী হেয়াত প্ৰায় ইগনোৰ কৰা হৈ যায়। যেনে মই ৱাইল্ড লাইফ ফটোগ্ৰাফী কৰোঁ, ৱাইল্ড লাইফ ফটোগ্ৰাফী কৰিলে মেনুৱেল ফ'কাচিং বা তেনেকুৱা ইউজ অফ ফ্লাছ খুব কমেই কৰা যায়। যদি মেক্ৰ' ফটোগ্ৰাফীত আহা তেতিয়াহ'লে মেনুৱেল ফ'কাচ কৰিবলগীয়া হয়, ফ্লাছ ইউজ কৰিবলগীয়া হয়, বেলেগ ইমেজিং টেকনিক যেনে ষ্টেকিং বা সেইবোৰো কৰিবলৈ অপৰচুনিটি পোৱা যায়। বহুত ধৰণৰ এছপেক্ট আছে যিবোৰ এই ফটোগ্ৰাফীৰ যিবোৰ মানে মেক্ৰ' ফটোগ্ৰাফীত ইনকৰ্পৰেট কৰিব পৰা যায়। এটা ডিষ্টিংগুইশ্ব মানে মানুহে কৰিব পাৰিব লাগিব, যিটো মেক্ৰ' ক্লোজ আপ আৰু এক্সট্ৰিম মেক্ৰ'ৰ মাজত ডিফাৰেঞ্চটো। মই বহুত ফটোগ্ৰাফীৰ ৱেব পেজ কিছুমান দেখা পাওঁ, ডেডিকেটেড মেক্ৰ' ফটোগ্ৰাফী পেজ, তাতো কিছুমানে ক্লোজ আপ ফটোজ ছাবমিট কৰে, একচেপ্টো হৈ যায়। কিন্তু there is a subtle difference between a close up and extreme macro and an extreme macro. So, in this photo, I will discuss this photo number one to basically close up. I have 50mm lens. I will just full to cover this. I will close up. It won't be a true macro. True macro will be a 1:1 aspect ratio. Basically, a 35mm zito amar full frame sensor hai eto jodi ami 35mm subject eta fill kori diu eto 1:1 presentation boli koy the second photo kon would be a true macro because it's more than 1:1 eto 1.5 man hobo x magnification sabo bole aru last kon hol extreme macro ekon pollen grain eta pollen sack eta re alisu that is at around 6x magnification. I have two photographs of the same subject taken on the same day, same camera and same settings, but they look different. There's just one parameter that has been changed, and what is it? If somebody can tell me.
Aperture.
Yes. So.
Depth of field.
Depth of field, yes. So aperture regulates depth of field. So there are two photos, same subject. One has been shot at f20, the other has been shot at f10. So. Rest of the settings are same. They are shot at 1320 at ISO 400 and the focal length is 150mm. So basically in macro, you have to play with your aperture so that you get the subject in focus. Aru subject ar jiman usorle jua hoy depth of field iman shallow hoy jay. Tarne area in focus to both thin hoy. Hetu karne ami aperture lot khelibologiya hoy. Ar jodi ami aperture to komai diu our depth of field bare kintu we lose light light jeti ami lose koru we have to compensate with an external source of light flash by led kono kata byabohar koribolagiya hoy and that limits our shutter speed karon maximum camera jibur ami use koru tahatar logot sync speed to basically 1/250th ba na janu moi Sony এটা ক্যামেরা পাইছিল যেটো 1320 থলকে হৈছিল যেটো মই ইউজ কৰিছিল সো বেসিক্যালি অ্যাপারচার হল যেটো লেন্সৰ ওপেনিং যেটো লাইট এলাউ কৰে যেটো এডজাস্ট কৰিব পাৰে পাৰি ব্লেডছ আছে তাতে ম্যাক্রো জেনারেলি ওয়াইডেস্ট অ্যাপারচার f2.8 লেন্স আৰু ডেডিকেটেড ম্যাক্রো লেন্স পুৰ f1.4 মানে জানো কিন্তু F2.8 is the maximum aperture that you can get. F2.8 tunia subject separation of bokeh phal baba, kintu depth of field bahut shallow hobo. Depth of field borhabo karone ami generally macro bohute F8 or pra F22 bhitor photograph tule. Eta bostu janibologiya hoy jitu bohute realize nokore je jitia aperture borhai goi thaku ami tetia diffraction kicks in. Diffraction is basically jodio focus of thake photo kini it photo looks a little bit cloudy not as sharp as it should aro sub lensor belek eta sweet spot thake and also it also depends on the megapixel of your sensor so camera lens combination aro lighter upor depend kori pala light iman matter nokore but the camera lens and the sensor these are the two main factors that plays with diffraction So as I told, that macro can be inexpensive. You don't have to use very expensive tools to start macro photography. So that can be inexpensive was to do all use of reversing rings. The reversing ring basically the filter ring type into camera lage. Apnal kemon dekha pai ase lage.
Yes, sir. Paisu, dekha paisu.
Okay. So, my dedicated reversing ring of macro photography karne to kinisilo eto lens. Eto reversing ring hai. Reversing ring to kina khomoy janibo lage je filter thread to size ki hoy jitu lens ami use korim. আৰু ক্যামেরার মাউন্টটো কি হয়? এইটো 50 mm হয় লেন্সটো, ফ্রন্ট এলিমেন্ট ফিল্টারটো 50 mm, আর নিকন যেহেতু মোৰ ক্যামেরা হয় নিকন এফৰ হে হয়, নিকন এফ মাউন্টৰ। ইবে বা এমাজনত কিনিব পাৰে, এইবোৰ বেছি দামো নলয়। মোষ্টলি মই ইয়াত 5 pounds দিছিলোঁ, ইণ্ডিয়ান প্ৰাইচত কনভাৰ্ট কৰিলে 500 মান হয়। এইটো ইউজ কৰিব পাৰি। ক্যামেরা তেনেকে লাগি যায়। সো বেসিক্যালি দি ফ্রন্ট এলিমেন্ট বিকামস ব্যাক, ব্যাক ফ্রন্ট, আর মেক্রো ফটো তুলব পারি এই দি। তার পিছর যে প্রাইস ওয়াইজ আপন ইনএক্সপেন্সিভ বলে কব পারি, এটি হল ইউজ অফ এক্সটেনশন টিউবস। এক্সটেনশন টিউবস পুরো আক ভেরিয়াস ব্র্যান্ড আর ভেরিয়াস কোয়ালিটির আহে। আটাইতকৈ ইনএক্সপেন্সিভ পুরো দাম হে বলে কয় এক্সটেনশন টিউবস। বেসিক্যালি সেইটোত কোনো ইলেকট্রনিক কানেকশন নাথাকে, হলো টিউব হয় ব্ল্যাঙ্ক। ক্যামেরা মাউন্ট কেটা থাকে ফিমেল আর মেল, তো এটা ক্যামেরা মাউন্টত যায়গে, ক্যামেরা এনেকে লাগি যাব। ভেরিয়াস হেয়ার থাকে টিউবস বোর লেন্থ ডিপেন্ডিং করে কোনটো ইউজ করিব পারি, এইবোৰ খুলি লগাই দিব পারি। ফিফটি এম এম লেন্স এটা যদি আমি 50 mm এক্সটেনশন টিউব লগাওঁ, তেতিয়া আমি 1:1 এসপেক্ট ৰেচিঅ' পাব পাৰোঁ। তাৰ পিছৰখিনি আহি যায় ডায়প্টাৰ বা সেয়া বুলি কয় ফিল্টাৰ্ছ। তাতে ভেৰিয়াছ ফিল্টাৰ্ছ ভেৰিয়াছ ব্ৰেণ্ডৰ পোৱা যায়। এটা মই বাকী ডিটেইলত দি আছোঁ বেলেগ এখন শ্লাইডত। এই তিনিটা ইনএক্সপেন্সিভ অপশ্যন হয়, বেছি দাম নলয় আৰু ভাল ইমেজ কোৱালিটিৰ আৰু শ্বাৰ্প ফটো তুলিব পৰা যায়। ৰিভাৰ্চিং ৰিং বেছিকেলি কি কৰে, বেছি ছাবজেক্টটোক ডাঙৰকৈ দেখাই দিয়ে। ইয়াত বেছি ডেপথত নাযাওঁ, চায়েন্স বিহাইণ্ড ইট, বাট অল ইউ কেন চি ইজ ডাঙৰ বস্তুটো সৰুকৈ দেখা পাওঁ। যিহেতু আমি ইয়াত নৰ্মেল যেতিয়া আমি লেন্স ইউজ কৰোঁ, আমি ৰিভাৰ্চ কৰি দিলে তাৰ উল্টা ইফেক্টটো হয়। তাৰ আটাইতকৈ ডাঙৰ ড্ৰবেকটো হ'ল যিহেতু ফ্ৰণ্ট এলিমেণ্টটো বেক হৈ যায়, কোনো ধৰণৰ ইলেক্ট্ৰনিক কমিউনিকেশ্যন কেমেৰা আৰু লেন্সৰ মাজত নাথাকে। এপাৰ্চাৰ চেঞ্জ কৰিব নোৱাৰি, যিটো এপাৰ্চাৰত ফিক্স আছে সেইটো এপাৰ্চাৰ থাকি যায়। তাৰপিছত এক্সিফ ডাটাখিনি নোপোৱা, আৰু ইমেজ ষ্টেবিলাইজেশ্যন যদি ইন লেন্স ষ্টেবিলাইজেশ্যন আছিলে সেইটো পোৱা নাযায়। আৰু এক্সটেনশ্যন টিউব ইউজ কৰিলে যিহেতু টিউব আৰু আমাৰ লেন্সৰ মাজত এটা অবজেক্ট আহি গ'ল, সেইখিনি জেগাত লাইট লছ হয়, ছিগনিফিকেণ্ট এমাউণ্ট অফ লাইট লছ হয় কিন্তু টিউব ইউজ কৰিলে। সেইটো কাৰণে আমি অলৰেডি লাইট লছ কৰোঁৱেই, যিহেতু এপাৰ্চাৰ আমি কমকৈ ৰাখোঁ, তাৰ ওপৰে আৰু লাইট লছ হ'ব এক্সটেনশ্যন টিউব ইউজ কৰিলে। সেইটো আমি মনত ৰাখিব লাগে। আৰু যদি আমি ছিমিলাৰ প্ৰব্লেম পাব পাৰোঁ, যদি দাম যিকেইটা এক্সটেনশ্যন টিউব হয় যাৰ কোনো ইলেক্ট্ৰনিক কানেকশ্যন নাই, তে আমি এক্সিফ ডাটা আৰু ইমেজ ষ্টেবিলাইজেশ্যন হেৰাই দিওঁ। কিন্তু যদি ইলেকট্ৰনিক কমিউনিকেশ্যন থকা হয়, তেতিয়াহ'লে আমি এটলিষ্ট এপাৰ্চাৰ চেঞ্জ কৰিব পাৰোঁ, এক্সিফ ডাটাখিনি পাৰোঁ। অট' ফ'কাছ ইউজ কৰিব নোৱাৰোঁ যদিও অট' ফ'কাছ দিয়ে বুলি কয়, বিকজ মেক্ৰ' ফটোগ্ৰাফীত অলমষ্ট বহুত কঠিন বা টান হয় অট' ফ'কাছ ইউজ কৰাটো। আৰু এটা ডাঙৰ প্ৰব্লেম হয় যেতিয়া আমি এক্সটেনশ্যন টিউব ইউজ কৰোঁ, ডেপথ অফ ফিল্ড আৰু অকণ শ্যালো হৈ যায়, কাৰণ আমি ছাবজেক্টটোৰ ওচৰত গৈ ফ'কাছ কৰিব পাৰোঁগৈ। আৰু লাষ্ট অপশ্যনটো হ'ল মেক্ৰ' এডাপ্টাৰ্ছ। কম্পেৰেটিভলি এক্সটেনশ্যন টিউব আৰু সেয়াতকৈ অকণ কষ্টলি হয়, কিন্তু বেছি ফ্লেক্সিবিলিটি দিয়া যায়, লাইট লছ নহয় কোনো ধৰণৰ, যিহেতু ইলেক্ট্ৰনিক কমিউনিকেশ্যনটোত ইণ্টাৰফেয়াৰ নকৰে। তে ইমেজ ষ্টেবিলাইজেশ্যন দি লেন্স ৱৰ্কছ কমপ্লিটলি ফাইন বা নৰ্মেলি যেনেকৈ এজ ইট ছাপ'জ টু। অল ইট ডাজ ইজ দেৰ ইজ এন মেক্ৰ' এডাপ্টাৰ ইন ফ্ৰণ্ট অফ ইট এণ্ড ইট বেচিকেলি গিভছ এ মেগনিফাইড ইমেজ অফ ইয়াৰ ছাবজেক্ট। এটাটো ফিল্টাৰ টাইপ হয় যিটো ফ্ৰণ্টত লাগি যায় লেন্সৰ, ডিপেণ্ডছ অন দি লেন্স, লেন্সৰ ফিল্টাৰ চাইজটো কি হয়। আনটো হ'ল যিটো আই উড ৰিকমেণ্ড এভৰি মেক্ৰ' ফটোগ্ৰাফাৰ শ্বুড হেভ ওৱান, সেইটো হ'ল ৰেনক্স ডি চি আৰ 250 অৰ 150, ডিপেণ্ডিং অন কি ধৰণৰ মেক্ৰ' কৰিব বিচাৰে। চ' দিছ ইজ ৰেনক্স ডি চি আৰ 250। সেইটো কি হয়, adapter থাকে adapter টো এটা লগাও পাৰি স্ক্রু হৈ যাওঁ আৰু adapter টো স্প্রিং থাকে স্প্রিং লোডেড এইটো লেন্সৰ সন্মুখত লগাই দিব পাৰি এইটো যিকোনো লেন্স যাৰ ফিল্টাৰ সাইজ 67 mm বা তাতকে তলৰ হয় তাত লাগে আৰামছে তাৰ ওপৰ হলে এই এডাপ্টাৰটো নালাগে কিন্তু তেনেকুৱা লেন্সটো ইউজ কৰিব পাৰি মোৰ এটা মাইক্ৰো লেন্সত মই মাজে মাজে ইউজ কৰোঁ এইটোৰ ফিল্টাৰ সাইজ 72 mm হয় তে স্টেপ ডাউন ফিল্টাৰ এটা লগাই পেলাই স্টেপ ডাউন ফিল্টাৰটো 67 লৈ লৈ আহে তাতে এইটো লগাব পাৰি খালি এইটো লগালে কৰ্ণাৰ্ছবোৰত ভিনিটিং পোৱা যায় কিন্তু চেণ্টাৰত একেই মেক্ৰ' মেগনিফিকেশ্যনটো পোৱা যায় এই তিনিটা অপশ্যন হয় নাও এখন লেটছ ডিছকাছ চাম অফ দি ফটোগ্ৰাফছ চ' হোৱাট ইজ স্পেচিয়েল এবাউট দিছ ফটোগ্ৰাফ কোনোবাই যদি কয় ওকে Okay, got few replies. So, there's nothing special about this photograph as a photograph. It's special for me. Special for me because it was my first photograph using a reversing, first macro photograph using a reversing ring. মোৰ তাত ৰিভাৰ্চিং ৰিঙো নাছিলে একচুৱেলি আই জাষ্ট হেল্প মাই লেন্স উইথ ওৱান হেণ্ড উইথ ওৱান হেণ্ড আই হেড দি কেমেৰা এণ্ড আই টুক এ ফটোগ্ৰাফ এণ্ড আই কেপ্ট ইট চ' ইট স্পেচিয়েল ফৰ মি দেৰ ইজ নাথিং স্পেচিয়েল এবাউট দি ফটো দি ফটো স্পেচিয়েল দি ইজ দি মোমেণ্ট ৱেন আই কেপচাৰ্ড ইট এণ্ড দেট ইজ দি ইমেজ দেট কাইণ্ড অফ ইনস্পায়াৰ্ড মি টু গ' ইন টু মেক্ৰ' এইখন ফটো লোৱাৰ পাছত মই মেক্ৰ' অকণমান ছিৰিয়াছলি ল'লোঁ What about this one now? This was the first photograph that I was really proud of. It was well in focus. And there was another reason to be proud of. I am arachnophobic. Moi mokora le bahut bhoy korisilo. And this is the first time moi mokora ta usor jabo parisilo photo tulibo karone. Are ekhon photo tular pasot mur lahe lahe mokora proti bhoyo komi goise. এতিয়াও আছে তেৰণতোলা এটা দেখিলে চাগে মই এতিয়াও ওচৰলৈ নাযাওঁ কিন্তু মই মুখৰা ফটো তুলিব পৰা হ'লোঁ এইখন লোৱাৰ পিছত দেৰ ৱাজ সাম সৰ্ট অফ কনফিডেন্স দেট কেম টু মি এণ্ড দিছ ইজ অলছ' এ স্পেচিয়েল ফটোগ্ৰাফ বাট আই উইল মেনশ্যন এবাউট ইট এট দি এণ্ড অফ দি ছেশ্যন এণ্ড হোৱাট ইজ স্পেচিয়েল এবাউট দিছ ওৱান ইজ স্পেচিয়েল চ' দিছ ফটোগ্ৰাফ গট taken up by BBC Springwatch as one of the 10 best photographs for the year that was submitted in Flickr. And this was one of the two macro photographs that was accepted. And that sort of gave me a morale boost. This was also a motivation to continue photography. This particular photograph was taken with a 35 to 70 millimeter lens with a 35 millimeter extension tube. So the costly options of macro photography. So the costly option is if you go for a dedicated macro lens, which gives you 1-to-1 representation or 1-to-2 or even more. Or you can use enlarger lenses or you can use dedicated microscope objectives. So dedicated macro lens might look like this, which is this one is a Sigma. So I have a Sigma 105 and a Sigma 150 millimeter macro lens. Rueta has a Lawa 105. So 105 and 100 millimeter are almost similar, but the Lawa gives 1-to-2 representation. Are microscope objectives, which I'll discuss later. So a dedicated macro lens would be a little bit expensive compared to a using your kit lenses with extension tube or a Renox DCR250 or anything like that. You can do, what you get is an autofocus ability, although you would not be using it. You'll get optical stabilization. It'll give a good image quality compared to using extension tubes. Depth of field would be a little bit higher. Subject separation will help. So gear does matter. People, they're just saying that gear doesn't matter. A good photographer would make good photographs with a inexpensive gear. It is true, but what happens is you'll get one out of 90 shots, you'll get one good shot. Whereas if you have a good gear, you'll get all the 90 shots good. So it's like using an ambassador car in a Formula One race. You would need to compete at that level, you'll need a similar level of car. So here are two images to elaborate the same thing. I am the photographer. The subjects are almost similar. So the first photograph was taken with a kit lens, 18 to 55 millimeter with a 50 millimeter extension tube on it. It was photographed in Jeju Islands, South Korea, and it's a skipper butterfly almost, and a similar sort of flower. I don't know the species of the flower. The other is also a skipper butterfly from UK. Again, I have photographed it with a 150 millimeter macro lens. These photographs were taken 1 year apart. So I did have some sort of experience in macro, 1 year extra experience in macro, but you can see that using a dedicated macro lens, you can get better quality of image compared to an extension tube. This may not be an exact representation, but you do get some sort of advantage. That is what you pay for. So once the transition from you being happy with a 18 to 50 millimeter lens and a butterfly which is in focus, you become happy with that, then your focus shifts, you want to improve. Then you go for a dedicated macro lens, you get good subject separation, you get your subject in focus, and then you aspire for more. And then comes the other aspect. Then you would look for a good background. Even though you have a good shot, if it's not on a good background, you won't be happy that the background is not good. Background basically gives added value to your foreground. It hides it. So here is the same insect, which is a six-spotted barnet moth. Photographed on the same day, all parameters are same. The only difference is the background. And all I had to do was point my camera and the subject a little bit differently. So the first photo, this one was with the subject pointing towards a set of yellow flowers as your background. So you get a nice yellow background, whereas the other one was pointing it a little bit high and then taking the sky as your background to get a blue background. So once you are on the field, once you have stepped up from using a lens, using getting a subject in focus, being happy with it, and then you stepped up to getting images with bokeh and you love it, and then you step up to things like you want different backgrounds and how it looks in different background. I personally am a person who likes to get really close to subjects. Like I like going extreme. So macro can be subjective. Some people do not like going that way. Some people like more of a artistic way of expressing themselves. So they might go a little bit wide and express their photographs differently. So my talk won't go into the artistic aspect of it. My photographs or my talk would be more into the technical aspect of it and how to get close and how to get bigger images of small things. So once you have, suppose you have bought some extension tubes or Renox DCR250 and you want to step up the game and you bought a dedicated macro lens, what happens to your Rhinox DCR 250 or extension tubes? কি করিব পৰা যায়? So you can use it with your macro lens. The extension tube macro lens and ব্যৱহাৰ কৰিব পাৰি বা Rhinox DCR 250 macro lens লগাই ব্যৱহাৰ কৰিব পাৰি. It's not thrown away. You can use it again. The first photograph is of a hoverfly. I have used a 150 macro lens and I have used a 50 millimeter extension tube. The idea was to get close to the subject and get close to the subject as I can get, because I like to get close, as I mentioned. So the other image here is of a green shield bug, which I photographed with a 100 millimeter macro lens with Rhinox DCR 250. This is a stacked image of 35 photographs, whereas this is a single shot. Besides just photographing a subject and posting it on social media or keeping it, I would encourage people to learn about their subjects. So once you learn about your subjects, you'll learn some intricate behavior and other things about the insect that might help you with photography or that might help you with getting unique shots. So the first photograph is of a ladybug. So ladybug, what it does is it feeds on aphids. Kurute moi najanisilu ghorot amar agote bagisat deutak dekha pao deutae jiman enuka dhoroner pup dekhibo mari pelae koy je phul khai ba ai omita sumita hat kiba hile puke ahi khai boli mari die. Once I learned about it, I knew that it can be used as a biopesticide. Next time, my daughter go over, say to Maribo, "Na lage ito actually mare hai poop kya ta zira phol khai." On the other hand, we have ant and aphid. They have a different relationship. Ant and aphid are more of a symbiotic relationship. Ants pure protection diye from ladybug, but belag predator pura. In return, they get a sugar syrup which they carry to their nest. So this is one of those shots where you can see it has some sugar syrup that has been exited out by one of these aphids. Third, icon photo hall. This is a hornet mimicking hoverfly. Volucella zoneri, aito eukaryote damar hoverfly. So I came to know about it when I started photographing it. It was almost considered extinct in 1940s and it has revived itself. I was so intrigued by the hoverfly that I was one of the contributing members for the Hoverfly Statistics Society of UK. So I asked to give them photographs and let them know which area it was found. And the third one is getting rid of your fear. For me, it has been spiders. So I've been able to get rid of my fear once I knew the subject, that spiders are not as scary as they look. They might have 8 legs, but they're cool. You can, if you know what you're doing, they don't come and attack you. So it can be something else for you. It can be scorpions, it can be a cockroach, anything that scares you. If you learn about the subject or learn about it, you'll slowly start to appreciate it rather than be scared of it. The other thing is try to challenge yourself. Don't get stagnant at what you are doing. Try to do something more than what you are doing. So once I jetia photograph lo dhorlo jetia mo channel je mo kon thik ase ekarat mo phalke photo tibo paru eta bohi thaka pokila hok ba bohi thaka mahi mo hekata photo tulilo. Now challenge ki hobo, try to get them in flight. So atat ke hover subject hoverfly, because it hovers at one place and keeps hovering around. The item normally hoverfly ha the photo in flight to listen. So let's critique these two photographs and let's see what you can find out, what is good about it and what is bad about it. I'll give you 2 minutes and I'll wait for the responses. You can type in or you can speak. What have koi dilo bena pa type korlo moi bena pa. Okay, these were all taken in manual focus. There was no continuous autofocus used. I have used manual focus to photograph it.
Sir, first one, paki kihon mane focus hota hai. Second, second one, paki kihon halke focus hota aha nai. Shutter speed sagya kom paki sir.
Shutter speed aha. Do you want the shutter speed kom hai? That itu macro eta drawback. Zezi hetu moi in body flash itu hetu use kori aslo high speed sync flash use karna aslo. The itu shutter speed hai amar duota te limited hai. 1250 by 1320 limited. Almost really do that with that. Sabo lagibo. এখনতো এখন পাখি আহিছে কিন্তু পিছত অকণমান এটা শেডো এটা পৰিছে ইমান ভালকে দেখা নাই ইখন উত্তত ভালকে দেখা গৈছে শেডোটো কাৰণে ফ্ল্যাপ কৰা যেটো স্লো শাটাৰ স্পীডৰ কাৰণে ইফেক্ট আৰু এটা বস্তু সবে এই অন দ্য ফার্স্ট ফটোগ্রাফ এইখিনি জায়গাত রিফ্লেকশন এটা কাৰণ মই যেটো ফ্ল্যাশ ইউজ কৰিছিলোঁ ৰিং ফ্ল্যাশ আছিল সন্মুখত কোনো ডিফিউজন নাই তে হার্স লাইট যেতিয়া ইনসেক্ট বিশেষকৈ ইনসেক্ট আৰু ফুল মেক্ৰ আমাৰ ছাবজেক্টবোৰ ৰিফ্লেক্টিভ হয় বহুত কাৰণ চাইনি বডি হয় তাহাঁত ৰিফ্লেকশ্যনটো আকৌ মাৰিছে যিটোৰ কাৰণে বেছি অভাৰ এক্সপ'জ এৰিয়া হৈছে ইয়াতে কেইটামান যিটো ইয়াত মষ্ট প্ৰবলি নাই ইমান বেছি
ছাৰ প্ৰীতম নাথে চেটত কৈছে যে ইন ফাৰ্ষ্ট ওৱান বেকগ্ৰাউণ্ড ইজ এট্ৰেক্টিভ এজ কম্পেয়াৰ টু দ্য ছেকেণ্ড ওৱান
এগেইন It becomes subjective. এতিয়া কোনোবাটো বেলেগ কোনোবাই নাম্বাৰ টু খনৰ বেকগ্ৰাউণ্ডটো ভাল পাব পাৰে হাউ ইজ মিষ্টাৰ সেনি দেট ইজ দি চেলেঞ্জ অফ দেট ফটোগ্ৰাফ দেট ইউ হেভ টু মেনুৱেলি ফোকাছ এ স্মল ইনচেক্ট দেটছ অলৰেডি ফ্লাই It is possibly perseverance and keep trying. The good thing about hoverfly is it hovers at one place for a few seconds and then it moves. So if you can time it better, you can take some shots. Like if you take, I use the Nikon D500, which takes 10 frames a second. So out of the 5 frames, there would be one or two that is good in good focus. Now cameras like Canon R5 or Sony A1, they take around 20 to 30 frames per second. So if you spray and pray, you might get something in focus. Okay, let's move on. So once you have, like for me, my transition was once I have got to 1x, then I wanted to get closer. I got 2x, then I saw some extreme macro photographs on the internet. And I was really intrigued and I wanted to do it and I didn't know how to do it. So I did my research. So anything beyond 5x. So there's a Canon lens called Canon MPE65, which is a 1 to 5x magnification macro lens. So I've seen photographs taken with that and it kept intriguing me. I wanted shots like that, but I use a Nikon. So I wasn't able to get that kind of shots, because I cannot mount a Nikon lens on a Canon, although there should be some way of doing it. So I came to know that it needs special equipment, it needs special hardware, it needs special software, but you can again start with nothing and then keep going up. So how Extreme Macro started for me is that there was a microscope that was getting disposed of in the lab. That was the advantage of for me because I was working in a science lab that has microscopes. So this three lenses that you can see with 2.5, 4, and 10 region on it. These are the three objectives that was in that microscope. So I took permission from the PI, principal investigator, whose equipment it was getting disposed of, that if I could borrow some parts of the microscope for my personal use. And they agreed. This is a 35-year-old microscope. So the objectives are 35-year-old. So I took this and I looked in the internet how to use it on a camera. So there are many ways of doing it and I found the cheapest way and then started with that. So this is a rudimentary setup. This is kind of not rudimentary, this is a little bit advanced. When I started, all I had was the microscope objective, the macro lens, the camera, and a manual rail with one flash. This is somewhere intermediate. I have kind of kept improving it with every iteration. This is mostly my fourth iteration of the macro setup. So in some of the macro photos, if you see a green background, that green background is this green bottle here. So once I moved into extreme macro, this was the first photograph that I managed to get out. And I'm really proud of it. This is a mosquito at 5x magnification. You can see its eyes. It's, I don't know what is this called scientifically, but you can see the organ that is used to suck blood and then the antennas. So for extreme macro, it doesn't have to be just an insect. You can use flowers to practice. So this is what I practiced, extreme macro photography. In extreme macro photography, the biggest challenge is keeping your subject still. So at that kind of magnification, very slight movement, even a little bit of air or someone walking past would shake the subject, and that would cause artifact in your image. Also, the depth of field. The depth of field is very shallow when you are using a 5x microscope objective or 10x. So you have to kind of stack your images. Staking kori bola kiba, staking nokori de, tenekua dhoronor image nohoy. Ei dukhon photot praye 40 ba 50 khon photo loi pelai belek belek depth of field dot ekeloge merge kora hoyse using a software. So these are basically some of the stacked shots of live subjects. So these are all shot in Sigma 150mm macro lens, which had a 4x microscope objective in front of it. So this is a vine weevil. These and these two are two species of lacewing, and this is a moth. So they were all photographed using almost the same lens combination. The only difference is that I used a electronic rail to take all those photographs. So this piece of equipment here is known as an electronic rail. So what it allows you to take your camera one step at a time. You can choose the interval that you want. So I, for those photographs, could be 10 or 5 micrometers. So it will take the camera 5 micrometers. It will stop there, take a shot, move, take a shot, move, take a shot. So there are two ways of doing it. There is one here, the one I used to use previously, is a manual one where you have knobs where you push it, it goes forward, you take a photo. So you don't take photos by pressing the shutter button. You have to use a shutter release for that. I don't know where I kept it, I haven't. So you push your camera a little bit forward, you take a shot, and then you move it forward, take another shot. That's how it's done. So the first time I used something like that was using a microscope plate mover. So I used to fix my camera there, use it. And then from there, I went to a manual rail, from manual to electronic rail. So using a manual rail, you can get good shots at 5x magnification, but anything beyond 5x, you would need an electronic rail. Otherwise, the stack photos won't come sharp because the movement would be uneven. So these are all at 4x magnification. These are all using electronic rail. And these are at 10x magnifications. So there is the one with the green background is a honeybee drone, an European honeybee drone. And the one on the left is a weevil, grapevine weevil, if I'm not wrong. So these are all stacked photographs. So what is focus stacking? So when you are going into extremes of macro, the depth of field is almost 1 or 2 micrometer. So it's very shallow. You'll have just 1% of the eye in focus, not the whole eye. So what you have to do is you have to take multiple shots of the insect. Now it's a challenge on field with live subjects. So these four insects are all alive. So when they were photographed, they were alive, but these two are not. These are dead insects that I have collected from the road. These are roadkills. You have to look carefully with, these all have their abdomens smashed or some part of the body that has been smashed. It takes almost 1 hour or 2 hours to first prepare the insect. It goes through a few chemical treatments and it has to be dried up before it's put on a stage and then you photograph it. So the whole process of taking one shot, one stack shot, what I'm saying is like generating one photograph from all these stack shots, and from preparation to the end takes around 5 to 6 hours. So you can take multiple images and then you can use certain softwares to do this taking. Photoshop can do it. So what Photoshop can do is it can stack it, but it doesn't do it really well. There are two softwares, Xerin or HelicanSoft. They are two competing softwares. They're really good. Xerinot JPEG lage photo kini, raw photo tanate hai koi gunware. File format JPEG aru TIFF. Our HelicanSoft DNG file accept correct and a raw file accept kuriyo pare. Moi HelicanSoft use koru hetu karne. Atatke namar problem extreme macro gole hol movement. Jo koisu moi movement by ghosting artifact eta hai. Bikhekhe jeta three dimensional issue eta hai. Jeta ei puktur ei hundal agot ase ata pisot ase puktu. Jeta ami photo loi koi thaku prothome ei ketal focus ot lobo. Episode piece area can focus a lobo or the staking coraza software of conman stack code a kini jagat ghosting was on stake. More episode bird they come to the sun's from the icon photos of ghosting artifact asset. So current setup to more almost an equa bottom and naiver more setup to tell you the last year more final setup. So flash agate use curriculum one. So I got my flash use curriculum, remote shutter at a select data flash use curriculum. So final iteration more flash, but the LEDs I use a marble slab. I use it, Arupo Arata slab. I say immobilized Kubo Karne can't boot movement. Upper Lorata say he Doraduri Kurila flat at Kutesa post to. Pass control kam aku beginning or kori bola gaya hai. Aar mool bharte ita nisar swale jani hoy sa. So, hey to set up loi pala extreme portraits logo para jai. Especially, kuru pukura. Ito yata common blue bottle fly, ne green bottle, blue bottle fly. Jiko na ta hopare, bhena maki bili ka upam ya. এটো বলুছলা জনেরিয়া হয় কভার ফ্লাই আর এটো এটা হরু মকরা অলমোস্ট 2 মিলিমিটার মান সাইজের মকরা হয় এনেক পোর্ট্রেটস লব পারে এটো এবর দিজ আর অল 10x এইবর কারণে মই বেলেগ এটা অবজেক্টিভ কিনিছো নতুন কে এটো নিকনর হয় নিকনর 10x অবজেক্টিভ হয় Bahiro, so the Tatke extremes of the story. I mean, Hitu Paro. Econ Hall, at a Mumaki, Bori, even Porikon or Agor, but Econ Photo Hall at a Borolor, Hungal Zidalyamak Hane, but Zitia Camber Bully, someone hidden an excellent Camber Mandible disease, Tore, mean Idalti, whom I did poison insert group or poison venom insert group. This, can anyone say what is this in this photograph? Yes, eyes of what? Yes, these are the eyes of a mosquito. So, my prathamote ekhon photo dekhaisilu mohor. What is special about it? So this shows my transition. So I started macro photography, photographing this sort of images of a mosquito, from which I transitioned into this, and I finally arrived at this one. So those little eyes of the mosquito would look this big in 4x and this big in 20x magnification. So this is my story of macro photography. There could be, people can have different transitions. People do different sort of very artistically, aesthetically good looking macro photography with a lot of curves and other things. I didn't go this way, more as a scientist, that my mind works in a different way, more of a technical challenge rather than artistic challenge. You know, the challenge will help out. So now a very important aspect of macro photography is lighting and diffusion. As you have seen, I have used different sorts of lighting. It is very important because we will be shooting at very low light situation, not low light situation. We make it a low light situation by using a higher aperture. So there are two thoughts of school. There is use of flash, there is use of continuous light, and the jury is out there. They are equally good if you know how to use it. If you don't know how to use it, they're equally bad, because flash, you'll get a lot of overexposed areas if it's not diffused properly. LED has a problem of flickering. The shutter speed thicker rakha na jay, flicker has image burat. A diffusion of garnet, I have tried different materials, starting from white plastic to white cloth, as you can see in one of those images. So you have seen I've used white cloth for diffusion, and in these I used white sort of, these are white thermostat plates. So I've used different sort of things, but you have to arrive at your own, which one you like. Tracing paper bhal hoy aur jodi on field macro kore kunubai ar diffusion kar diffuser bahut bahut dhoroner diffuser market ase kinibole paoa jay, kintu I have seen one particular college made by a guy called, I don't remember his name, kintu India roy beetle diffuser boli koy aur jodi kunubai horseshoe mounted flash use kori ase macro karne, results are really good. Bahut bhal, people won't be able to tell if you have used a flash or not. Iman duniya diffusion, which I highly recommend. If somebody wants to buy it, they can buy it. I'm not paid by him. I don't even know him though. But I have seen really lovely images. And even I would like to buy two. If I go to India, I'll have to buy two of them. Coming to ethics, again, lighting, you can play with light, you can get backlit shots, you can get you can play with lights from different angles and you can get different artistic shots, which people try, which I have never, I'll have to try in future. Now coming to the ethics, which has been a burning topic recently in many of the social media, especially with birding in Assam. My only advice would be, don't kill any insect to photograph them, except mosquitoes. Feel free to kill mosquitoes. All my mosquitoes photographs that I have taken, apart from the first one, even the first one got killed after I photographed him. So they were killed. Rest of them are all dead sort of insects that have been revived using chemical sort of reviving techniques. And try to understand the behavior of the insect. Tahatar behaviors and photo to libo para jay. There are few sort of flies and honeybees, solitary honeybees, that sleep at night. basically on a twig. তাহাঁতৰ বেছি মুভমেণ্ট নকৰে, বহুত ফটো তুলিব পৰা যায় ধুনীয়াকে, ইউ কেন মুভ ইট এৰাউণ্ড। য়েছ, আই এম মাই পাৰ্চনেল বিলিভ ইজ ইফ ইউ মুভ এন ইনচেক্ট ফ্ৰম চামৱেৰ, চাপ'জ ফুল এটাত আছিলে, ফুলপাহ তুমি লৈ আহিলা, ফটো তুলিলা, ডোণ্ট জাষ্ট থ্ৰ ইট এৱে, পুট ইট বেক ৱেৰ ইট ৱাজ, ডেট শ্বুড বি ফাইন। তাৰপিছত আৰ্লি মৰ্ণিং ফৰ ইনচেক্টছ, আই ইউজ টু গ' আউট এভৰি ডে আৰ্লি মৰ্ণিং টু ফটোগ্ৰাফ ডেম ৱেন আই ইউজ টু ফটোগ্ৰাফ ডেম ইন দ্য ফিল্ড। বহুত ভাল টাইম হয়, সেইখিনি টাইমত ভাল ফটো তুলিব পৰা যায়। So how can you understand the behavior? By observing it, like mokora kisuman ase, some of them rely on their camouflage. They, you can really see it, try to hide themselves, but they don't run away. They'll stay there, immobile. Heburo photo tulibo para. Pokhila, on the other hand, is a different thing. Person, you would understand its behavior. Usar kale uri jai. So, once you are out there, eta pokhila dekhile tumi photo tulibo gala, all of usar pala uri gol, ako usar gala, ako uri gol. Don't waste your time. Behavior to janile tumi time waste koribo nalage, you'll always get another opportunity. Thik teneke, most probably my photo ekhon share koribo paru. So, ase jodi mu korbo. So, অসমত পোৱা যায়, ইয়াত পোৱা নাযায় বস্তুটো। ইটছ এ এণ্ট মিমিকিং স্পাইডাৰ, মই ফটো তুলিছিলোঁ এইখনত। তাৰ বিহেভিয়াৰটো চালে গম পাব যে ইট বিহেভছ লাইক এন এণ্ট, মুভমেণ্ট এণ্ট। ইভেন আই ৱাজ ফুল, মই এণ্টৰ ফটো, পৰুৱাৰ ফটো বুলিয়ে মই লৈ আহিছিলোঁ। মই ঘৰ ওপৰত ছাদত গৈ ফটো তুলিছিলোঁ, পৰুৱা বুলি ফটো তুলিছিলোঁ। তুলি পেলাই ঘৰ যেতিয়া ভিতৰলৈ আহি এডিট কৰিবলৈ চাওঁ, ভালকৈ যেতিয়া চাইছোঁ, আই গট ফুল, ইট ৱাজ এ স্পাইডাৰ। তাৰপিছত আকৌ কেইদিনমান গৈ পেলাই আকৌ তাক অবজাৰ্ভ কৰিছোঁ, তেতিয়া বুজি পাইছোঁ হাউ ইট বিহেভছ। ই বেচিকেলি পৰুৱা খায়, আৰু পৰুৱাকেইটাৰ ওচৰে পাজৰে এনেকৈ মুভ কৰিব যেন সিও এটা পৰুৱা হয়, যদি পৰুৱা বেছি কাষ চাপে ধৰি পেলাই খাই দিয়ে। So this, I would end my talk with this. It was really good and kind of Cotton College University Photography Club to invite me for this talk, and special thanks to Tushar Bhuiya for arranging everything. And I'll take questions now. Feel free to ask me anything.
Thank you, sir. Bahut bhale lagil session too. And it was really amazing. The photos were, you know, absolutely amazing. So we would love to have questions from the participants. So karobar jodi kiba question ase, please feel free to ask. You can unmute yourself and ask, or if you don't feel comfortable like that, you can write down your questions in the chat box.
Okay. So in the meantime, I'll start sharing a screen with my other favorite photographs. So it will be playing in the background as a slideshow.
Okay, sir. We have a question from Pritam Nath. Sir, if we have to shift from mobile photography to DSLR, kunbul features sai shift kora tu proyojon?
Adat ke damar feature hol budget. Budget kiman hai? Depending on budget, you'll have to buy. Tarpisot, if you are just photography karne jodi loi asa, ketiaba ki hoy manuhar your interest change. তুমি আজি মেক্ৰ'ৰ কাৰণে ফটো তুলিম বুলি কেমেৰা এটা লৈছা, পাছত তোমাৰ মষ্ট ৰেভলি চৰাই ফটো তুলিহে ভাল লাগে, বা তুমি পৰ্ট্ৰেইটছ লৈহে ভাল পোৱা, তো ইয়'ৰ ইণ্টাৰেষ্ট মাই চেঞ্জ। চ' ইউ বাই চামথিং ডেট কেন ডু এভৰিথিং, লিটল বিট মাষ্টাৰ অফ অল, অ' মে বি জেক অফ অল, মাষ্টাৰ অফ নান, তেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ কেমেৰা। অ'কে, চ' এতিয়া I would say that DSLR, it would be wise if you go for a mirrorless camera, because slowly and slowly DSLR will be phased out. I think DSLR has a life of another 5 to 10 years. After that, it might be history. Okay, what is the next question?
Sir, তাৰপিছত আলেখ্য ধনদিয়াৰ প্ৰশ্ন আছে,
স্যার, ইজ ইট 140?
ইয়া ইয়া হেতো, ইয়েস।
You can use 18 to 140 for reverse ring, but in the shorter distances, you cannot use it at 140 millimeter. So there has to be somewhere between 18 to 35 millimeter. Beyond that, you might not get good images. Can aperture control depth of field in macro? Yes, apertures do. So if you are using a macro lens or any lens, if you're capturing macro photographs, you have to shoot it at an aperture of around f8 to f16 so that you get a better depth of field, but it still won't be enough to get whole subject in focus. You will get some bit of the animal in focus or insect in focus. How to take good pictures using 70 to 300 millimeter? Use a Renox DCR 250 macro adapter in front of it and an external flash. Keep practicing and you'll get good photos. 60 to 300 also same, Renox DCR 250. I can highly recommend. Canon, Sony, Nikon, best features of each according to you. So camera doesn't matter when it comes to macro photography, it's the lens that you are using. The camera can be anything. So either camera is fine. All you need is a good lens and then what you want to do with it. Do you want to use a macro lens for macro photography or do you want to use the cheaper alternatives like using a macro adapter? Okay, for all the mobile macro photographers, I'm sorry I cannot reply because I have never taken a single shot with one of my mobiles for macro. I have seen good images. The only problem shooting with what I have found with dedicated macro lenses on mobile is some of them have a very low resolution sensor of around 2 megapixels, which is not good when you print. Anto problem hall camera jitu camera sensor size hoy mobile bahut khuru hoy itia iman advanced ona technology je iman khuru sensor bhal image quality pa jabo printer khomoy print lobo bole he bor sobote noise pa jabo for focus. Okay, clip use or mirror lens camera mirror lens na mirrorless wildlife use koribo pari Sony A7 of series 2 ba Canon R5 series R5 R6 hekata duniya ke koribo pari dia evolve hoy ase, give it some time. Focus lens is best. Acha Rishab Bordole, macro photography karne auto focus lens loleo most of the time manual focus e koribologiya hobo karon focus lote bahut time lage ahi khini khomot hoyto puk tu uri jabo ba he jagat na thake jodi pukor photo li ase jodi fuller photo to li ase tenuka subject hole pari best macro lens mur mote sigma 105 to hoy best value for money dam wise kom hoy optical stabilization bhal hoy image quality to Canon ba Sony tahato lens r koman ekebhal image quality diye. Reverse ring 50mm primer pari hoy pari e moy primer to korisaisu moy 18 to 55mm to reverse koribaisu ekdam arambhoni jeta korisilo 18 to 55 gyan bora tumak koyisu 18 to 55 at use korisilo moy reverse ring aro moy jeta 50mm f1.8 ekhon kinisilo tetiao moy paru eta kotha hoy jodi Nikon user hoy Nikon user hole ki hoy je jete reverse kora jay lens re aperture control korbo no lens re aperture control koribo karone yate ta bustera ase etu lorsor korle aperture change hoy Canon ot lens purot lens to fit kori pelai aperture set kor dile he aperture lens to thaki jay Nikon ot enuka no hoy etu karone eta upay ase most probably thakibo lage মোর ম্যাক্রোর এটু এটা হ্যাঁ হয় ফিল্টার টু পোলা হয় ইয়াত সব ধরনের ফিল্টার পাওয়া যায় এটু এটু ক্যানন টু নিকন লেন্স অ্যাডাপ্টার হয় ইয়াত এটা বস্তু আছে এইটোয়ে এইটো দি পেলাই বস্তুটো অ্যাপারচারটো মেইনটেইন করিব পারি যদি রিভার্সিং করা প্রাইম এটা এনেকুৱা এটা রিং এটাতো রিভার্সিং রিং লাগিলে এইটো পিছপিনে লাগিব ক্যামেরাত আর এটা লেন্সৰ যেটো ব্যাক টু ফ্রন্টত আহি যাব সেইটোর কারণে এইটো লগাই দিলে অ্যাপারচারটো কন্ট্রোল করিব পারা যায় রিভার্সিং এর কারণে আর ইস 24 মেগাপিক্সেল এনাফ ফর ম্যাক্রো ফটোগ্রাফি ইজ মোর দেন এনাফ ইভেন 10 টু 12 মেগাপিক্সেল ইজ গুড এনাফ দ্যাট ইজ ধাইরিয়া শর্মা
স্যার আই থিঙ্ক আৰু কোৱেশ্যন নাই চাগে পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্টছ খিনিৰ যদি কাৰোবাৰ কিবা আছে সুধি ল'ব পাৰে এতিয়া
Yes.
We're ending the webinar. আৰু আমি ফিডবেক ফৰ্মৰ লিংকটো চেটত দি দিছোঁ ইউ গাইজ উইল হেভ টু ফিল আপ দ্য ফৰ্ম টু গেট ইউৰ ই চাৰ্টিফিকেট এণ্ড দ্য লিংক উইল বি একটিভ ফৰ 20 to 25 মিনিটছ চ' আৰু কাৰোবাৰ যদি কিবা কোৱেশ্যন আছে ইউ গাইজ কেন আছ
অলছ' মই ছ'চিয়েল মিডিয়াত ফেচবুকততো আছোৱেই ইউটিউবতো আছোঁ এজ মাই নেম জয়ন্ত বৰদলৈ তাতেও মেছেজ কৰিব পাৰে বা ইনষ্টাগ্ৰামত ফেচবুকত সাধাৰণতে ডিপেণ্ড কৰে মই চবৰে ব্লাইণ্ডলি ফ্ৰেণ্ড ৰিকুৱেষ্ট একচেপ্ট নকৰোঁ হ'লেও মেছেজ দিলে ৰিপ্লাই দিব চেষ্টা কৰোঁ মই
ছাৰ আই থিংক আৰু কুৱেশ্যন নাই চাগে আমি ছেশ্যনটো এণ্ড কৰি দিব পাৰোঁ
আচ্ছা
So thank you everyone for joining and a big thanks to Jayanta Bolle sir for giving us his precious time aro enedore apunaloke nije kiba picture click korile sarok dekhabo pare you guys can text him in social media and you guys can also show it to us ami sarok dekhabo paru aro yes eta bondho lockdown partial lockdown so keep clicking and rest noloba ketao always improve never settle for I think So with this, I would like to end the session today. Ami aru next belik belik topic of session korim. Gotike sobe please groupot thakiba, WhatsApp group to thakiba. Ami tat amar next session boror links bo di thakim. Aru thank you everyone. You guys can leave. I'll stop the meeting now. I'll end the meeting now. Thank you.